In this video, we are going to talk about this infrared sensor module, how it works, how to use it, test it with different materials, and the example project with Arduino or ESP-based board like NodeMCU. This is very popular infrared sensor, since it is easy to use and very cheap. Most Arduino learning kit even has this sensor. The sensor can detect object or obstacle in front of it. It has two LEDs. The transparent one is the LED that transmits infrared light, and the black one is the photodiode that can sense the infrared light. When it is powered up, the infrared is always on or always transmit the light. So when there is an object in front of the LED, the infrared light will bounce back. And when the photodiode receives the infrared light, it will give signal to the circuit. In the circuit, there is a comparator. When the signal is above the threshold, the circuit will give output low. When the signal or the signal is below the threshold, it will output high. We can adjust the threshold or the sensitivity or the distance of the sensor by rotating the trim pot or potentiometer on the circuit. To make the sensor detect farther, we should rotate to right. To make it closer, we can rotate the trim pot to the left. To use it with a microcontroller like Arduino, we can easily just connect the sensor pins to our board. Follow this wiring diagram. It has three pins: VCC, ground, and also the output. You can connect the VCC to 5V, ground to ground, and of course the signal to the digital pins of Arduino. After the wiring is done, let's just connect the USB cable to the Arduino. And as you can see on the right of the sensor module, there is an LED that lights up when the sensor detects an obstacle in front of it. Let me turn off the lamp to see it clearer. Now, let's have a little experiment with this sensor. I will put three different objects in front of the sensor. The first is heatsink, made from metal. As you can see, the sensor can detect the object which is a heatsink from far enough. It is about 11 centimeters. Without adjusting the sensitivity, let's try the second object, which is white paper. And the sensor can detect this at a distance about the same as a heatsink. Now, the third object is a black box made from plastic. And this is very different than before. This box needs to go about 2 cm from the sensor to get detected. So this means that the sensor depends on how the object reflects the light back to the sensor. Black objects tend to absorb more than reflect it, and so is the white paper and glossy metal. It is more reflective. So you need to be more careful with the sensor. Different materials and colors can affect the distance of the sensor. Now I will try to adjust the distance by rotating the trim pot to right. And that seems to be working. Now the black box is detected in a longer distance. It is about 10 centimeters. And when I rotate the trim pot to the left, it is detected in shorter distance. Open the Arduino IDE and let's start programming. Since the program is very simple, just read the digital input on pin 2 of Arduino. I will edit the example of digital read on Arduino example files. If you are very new to Arduino and not sure what is going on, you can take my course on Arduino Basic. Link in the description below. I will just rename the variable to IR and IR state. Then upload the sketch and open the serial monitor to see the result. The sketch will print 0 when the input is low and print 1 when the input is high. So when there is an obstacle, it will print 0. I will add "Hey, move out" on the serial monitor when there is an obstacle in front of the sensor. Like I said before, when you are using another board like NodeMCU, it should work the same way. In this video, I also demonstrate how to use it with a NodeMCU. Just follow this wiring diagram. And edit the pin's name according to your wiring. In this example, I use the D3 pins. Then don't forget to change the board and upload it. And that's it. It works the same way. Now I will make a simple project. When the obstacle is detected, it will trigger a lamp to light up. So I will hook up a relay module to the Arduino. This is the wiring diagram. And as you can see, the lamp will turn on when my hand in front of the sensor. With the same way, you can also use the NodeMCU. You just need to edit the pins on the sketch. And that's it, works too on NodeMCU. And one more, I found that when this sensor is exposed to the sun, it will always like detecting an object. Maybe because it detects infrared light from the sun, so this sensor cannot be used outdoor. So I think this is the end of video. If you think this video is useful, consider like and subscribe. And if not, you can still subscribe to make me happy. Ha 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 ha. Thank you.